What is up, guys, and welcome back to a brand new video. Today we're doing another 100% raise, this time for the Bahrain short layouts. If you want to see the Bahrain outer layout in a video, check out my one from yesterday. We did the outer layout on Assetto Corsa, and we also did the oval layout. There's an actual oval layout at Bahrain, believe it or not. So we did both of those in the same video, link in the description. But let's get back to this one. This is an online race, 100% race. Codemasters haven't done the math for this because it's still 57 laps, assuming that we take the full circuit. But it's 57 laps with a short circuit. So it's not a true 100% race, but it's the biggest, it's the longest distance we can run with this layout. If we did this by distance, like in real life, like they're doing for the outer layout, it should be around 87 to 90 laps, potentially. So, that would be the true length. We're doing 57 laps today, but I just thought I'd make that mention to you guys. Okay? We're skipping out in qualifying because it's a long race, and we don't know the potential of all the people in this lobby. There's a lot of time to make up the difference, and so you would assume that there would be at least a couple of safety cars in this race. So that's why we've taken ourselves out of qualifying, and we'll be starting from P12. Surprisingly, a lot of people either crashed or cut the corner or something and didn't get a time in themselves. So that's a lot higher up the grid than what I was anticipating to be in. But if you want to take part in these lobbies, all you got to do is follow me on Twitter, link in the description, Instagram as well. I actually put out an Instagram story for this race. So we had a pretty good turnout, despite it being around 1 a.m. that I did this lobby in the UK. So that was amazing to see the lobby fill up so quickly. So thank you. But here we go for the race. Bahrain short, 100% race, starting from P12 on the grid. Let's see if we can win this one as we go off now. So looks like an okay start. We move up into P10. There's a safety car. Oh, wow. There was a Ferrari that got spun out. They went into the outside barrier, and before anyone could get to turn one, we already lost someone in this race. That is crazy. So very unfortunate to oh man, lap one, not even turn one of such a long race and you're out. That's got to be so disappointing. That's a, imagine spectating for the rest of the race. That's a long time to wait. But yeah, safety car has been deployed. I'm going to come in and I'm going to put the medium compound tyres on. It's a good chance to knock off a pit stop. And oh, the Haas has jumped me in the way into the pit lane. And I think they're going to get away with that. That's Young Bean in the Haas. That's low-key amazing. I was playing a very safe into the pit lane. And safety car rules don't apply when you commit to the pit lane. So I think that's a legal move. Unbelievable. But we jumped him anyway in the pit stop, so that was all for nothing, I suppose. Maybe he had some front wing damage or had to change a wing or something. Either way, that was a very exciting entrance into the pit lane. Who's this guy? Red Oblivion in the AlphaTauri, falling off the circuit. Thought I could get his position, but he pits anyway. So that moves us up into P11 in this race. So the laps are going to go flying by thick and fast. Because it's only a sub 60 second lap time around here. And so by that reckoning, I think tyre wear will be pretty low. We may be able to do most of the race, or we should be able to do most of the race on this medium compound tyre. The intention now is to probably go to the softs towards the end, and that'll be my strategy, depending on more safety cars. We could go mediums again in 20 laps or something and then go to the end. I don't know, but the intention is to go back to softs. But safety car is coming in at the end of this lap. There's a bit of kerfuffling going on up ahead. A bit of contact being made. I didn't get a good restart because of everyone coming to a halt. But looks like we're maybe going to be in a position to overtake heading down into turn one. There is a yellow flag, though. We're going to have to time this well. Still can't overtake. Yellow flag goes away, and we're back to green flag running. Once again, as you can see, the Mercedes right behind us trying to overtake. There's a Williams that's gone off there at turn three, and now this is going to be a little bit awkward as the Williams has given us the big squeeze off the circuit. Let's see if we can get this move done. The Renault up ahead is not in this race anymore. The person left three wide down here. And the Renault comes out on top in the AI car somehow. So that was rather odd. But we finally got through and we're into P9. Hopefully now things will calm down a little bit and we can settle into a little bit of a rhythm. But this is, you know, after all, an online lobby. And there's no such thing as calm in these kind of lobbies. It's going to be three wide. My teammate has left the session. It's going to be three wide up the middle. Ferrari moves to the inside and gives us the squeeze. Nearly squeezed us into our teammate. We got the job done. And that's P7. So swiftly making our way through the field in this race. I don't think too many people stopped for new tyres. And, you know, if they did, they went back to soft. So I'm one of the very few people in this race at the moment on mediums. And this is going to be good for us long term, as we have the flexibility to go back to softs later and be faster later. Whereas I think other people around us are going to have to go to mediums and will be slower later on. So I think we're in a pretty good position in this race, as Esteban Ocon up front sets the fastest lap of the Grand Prix. And the safety car has been deployed for the second time in this race. So this, again, throws another cat amongst the pigeons. The race leaders, who didn't stop under safety car, they're going to be stopping. They might stop now, maybe. We'll just have to wait and see there. The majority of them are on softs. And look at that, the race leaders are in. The only person who stays out is the Haas right in front of us. So that promotes us up in a P2. So that early strategy call to dive it in under the first safety car to, you know, essentially throw away that track position has thrusted us into a good position now. But here's the running order. Esteban Ocon, P6 on mediums. He's one to watch out for. Yellowish Star is also pretty fast too. Hoopalicious, fast driver in the Ferrari. They're the ones to watch out for, I would say. And now we've got the Haas making a stop too, which gives us the lead of the Grand Prix. He's got a drive-through to serve. So we now lead this race, and there's a flurry of drivers behind us, all with penalties or soft compound tyres on. So we're in a very good position in this race. Our tyres are slightly older than those who just stopped, the likes of Esteban Ocon there in P5, who has the fastest lap against his name at this stage. He's going to have, I think he's got like 7 lap fresher medium compound tyres on, and that may prove to be handy later on. But for the short term, we have the ascendancy in this race. You can see where, I don't know, we're messing around with the safety car. Oh, and I've touched it! I looked back for a second, I looked forward, and then the safety car kind of swerved at me, or I swerved at it. Normally, you can't get away with that. This is an example from the older F1 games. If you touch the safety car, you got disqualified instantly. And, I just goes to show you how lucky I was, how lucky I am to still be in this race. Another one which springs to mind is one of my first ever viral video was the safety car explodes my car. Safety car touched me then. It destroyed my car, obviously, but I also got disqualified on impact too. So, things I never thought I would be able to do and get away with back in the day. You can get away with murder on this game. But anyway, we're getting ready for the restart. We lead off the Bahrain Grand Prix once again. The Sakhir Grand Prix, I guess I should call it, since this isn't the full-length Bahrain circuit. We're underway and heading down into Turn 1. I've gone in a bit deep, which is one thing, but the tyres and brakes were still pretty cold at this point. And I think that really caught me out. So that was a bit of a shaky restart from me, I'm not going to lie. But it's a restart nonetheless. We've still got our front wing. We still have the lead. And that's all I can really hope for at this early stage. Esteban Ocon, he was in fifth, dropped some places, some time. I don't know what happened, but he's got overtaken by a yellowish start on soft compound tyres. So those on softs, there's an entire train of cars behind me now on softs, and it's going to be my job to just keep them at bay. VSC is deployed, which, to be honest, doesn't change anything, as the majority of us in contention for the race win are not going past the pit lane, so that is absolutely fine. So yeah, like I said earlier, my intention now is to run long as I can, and then when we're within like the pit window for the final stint, if there's a safety car around like lap 35 to 45 or even 50, that's when we'll dive it in for softs, and that'll be my game plan towards winning the race, because I want to have the fastest tire on at the end, just in case there is a late safety car. The last thing I want to do is maybe box early, go for mediums or even hards, and then, you know, have crap tires that can't do anything towards the end. That's why you've really got to really plan ahead for these longer races, because there just can be a safety car at any time, and you don't want to be the person that's caught out on an older, harder compound tire and not able to defend your position, especially at a track like this where overtaking is going to be so easy because of the slipstreaming and DRS and what have you. But lap 21, life is looking pretty good. We've got a lead of nearly 10 seconds up over Esteban Ocon and Yellowish Star. They finally got their way through the traffic. We've been leading up front, running a very consistent pace in the mid-101s. And, you know, the tire feels really good. I'm lapping really close to my PB most laps. You can see my battery is running pretty low now. So probably getting to a point where I'm going to start backing it off. Look after the tires a little bit more so I can go deeper into the Grand Prix. But there's a VSC, and this could really help out my rivals behind if they dive it into the pit lane. Esteban Ocon, he stays out. He could have boxed for new tires, softs maybe, and gone to the end with maybe a free pit stop just about. My teammate let me go through, and now I've got to let him go back through. The VSC is ending. It's all happening now at this crucial stage of the Grand Prix, halfway through. VSC ends. We've lost a lot of time because I had an illegal overtake warning. And luckily it went away, because if I was going to get pinged there, that would have been a drive-through penalty, and my race could very well have been over then and there. But still, because I came to a stop, I lost that 10-second advantage that I had. And now the Racing Point driver is all over me once again. So this has now become a straight-up fight for the win once again. So this is going to be tough now to keep him at bay. You can see that's a small mistake on my part. And I think he's going to overtake here. I'm just going to let him go. He does have seven-lap fresher tyres than us. So that is slight cause for concern, but I'm not overly worried, believe it or not, because I felt like I had the pace on him, because I was pulling away from him when I was pushing all throughout this stint. So I'm not going to be too disheartened if he overtakes me here. And like I said, I can probably do with backing off a little bit, looking after the rear tires, running in lean revs a lot to look after those rears. But what it also does is it helps me save fuel for later. I want to be able to have enough fuel in the tank to be able to push, you know, qualifying lap after qualifying lap for like the last 10 laps, just so I've got something to fight with. That's all I'm doing, is just putting myself in a good position later on to be able to fight. And I've just noticed that Esteban Ocon has 3 seconds worth of time penalty, so he's cheesed some of the corners a little bit so far over the course of the race, which is it's easy to do. It's actually easy to track extend at some corners. You can cut here a little bit if you're not careful, and you can extend here. I get really close to the limits of extending there, but I make sure that I don't go over the limit. But to your surprise, I actually haven't cut a single corner. I haven't got a single warning for track limits this whole race. The only warning I do have is for touching the safety car. But that's, you know, that's nothing. So we're absolutely fine on track limit standpoint. Again, we're looking after ourselves for later, because we might need those track limit warnings later on if we're in a battle. But here we go. Pit window is now open. We move to the inside to overtake our Racing Point competitor. And we get up the inside and into the lead of the Bahrain Grand Prix once more. So now that we're getting close to the pit window, it might be time to, you know, start upping the ante a little bit, upping the pace. So we'll see if he can run with us for the time being. He's still there, 3/10 behind. The Ferrari goes a lap down. Now, crucially for this race, I've turned off ghosting. And I actually do that for a lot of my lobbies these days. It means that the lap cars don't ghost. And you actually have to overtake them. Makes it a little bit more of a challenge, I suppose. And overall, I tend not to like ghosting in these games. It means you actually have to avoid someone if they actually spin or crash in front of you instead of ghosting. I feel like it's more realistic, but that's just my personal opinion. Esteban Ocon fakes a move into the pit lane, but in the end, comes back out onto the circuit. I'm just running with him at the moment, just running in the slipstream in his DRS. You can see tire wear is getting up there pretty high at this stage, 66%. And that's, I guess, a bit of a concern for me because I didn't want to come in too early for the softs. I could have came in like 5 or 6 laps ago, but I was worried about what kind of tire condition I'd have left on the softs if I boxed that early. So what I'm doing is I'm elongating this stint here on the mediums just to make doubly sure we can go really long. We can easily push to the end on softs. That's my thinking here as we've retaken the lead on that last straight. But I'd say we're getting ready to come in very, very soon. That's a big mistake from me there. And I think we're going to lose the lead here. I'm not going to use any overtake to defend because I want to save that for a little bit later when it's more crucial. So we're back in the slipstream. We're back under the rear wing of Esteban Onco is his actual name. Hoopalicious is flying in the Ferrari, but he's pretty much a lap down at this point. So he's going to need a safety car to save him, his race. That's Red Oblivion, I think. Brake checking Esteban Onco there. Not sure if he lost any front wing. I didn't see any element of the front wing come flying off. So that was very lucky on his front not to get any damage there. That's the last thing I want. I want this battle to continue, and I don't want him to be at a handicap because of stupid lap cars or anything like that. We get the lead back. Had a little look at his elements of his front wing, and it looks fine. VSC has been deployed. And again... Oh, man. That is potentially a moment where we could have just lost the race right there. Esteban Onco would have dived it in under VSC. He would have won the race. He would have very well won the race right then and there because he would have gained like 10 seconds or so. I need to come in now for my soft compound tires. I was going to come in on that last lap, and then I thought I'll do one more. And the VSC nearly very ruined it all for me. So into the pit lane we go. The battle can continue onto the softs. I'm assuming Estab is going to do the same thing and go onto softs too. And he does. So this is going to be the fight to the end now. The battle for third. The third place is, 40 seconds behind. 15 seconds behind now after the pit stop. So we can afford to fight it out quite a bit for the rest of this race. It's going to be no holds bar, I'd say. But I think we gained a lot of time in the pit stop phases. I don't think Racing Point gave Ocon the good stop there. And so we gained a lot out of that. But on this lap in particular, we are absolutely flying. We're going to see if we can get the fastest lap and really put a full stop on this race to stamp our authority. So we'll see how it goes. Purple to the first sector. I think we were up by like 4 or 5 tenths, which is quite a lot over just like 2 corners. Heading into the second sector split now, trying to attack this corner, use up the full width of the circuit. I always just about manage to keep a tire, just inside the white line. And that's, aided me in able to not use up any track limit warning so far. Through the final corner, on the power nice and early, up in a rich and overtake. And this will be the first sub 60 second lap time of the race for me personally. And that could well be the best lap I do all race as the safety car is out again. I don't even know what to say at this point. This is what, the third or fourth safety? I think it's a third safety car. We've had probably just as many VSCs. But guys, this is exactly why I was planning. I was planning for this moment, the whole race. I knew that there was the potential for a late race safety car. We've now got soft compound tires on, which are still very fresh. Got a lot of life left in them. And we've got a lot of fuel to play with. So for the final 5 laps of this Grand Prix, it's going to be a shootout for us between ourselves, Esteban Onco, Anton, Yellowish Star. They're all in this train of cars, albeit with a lot of lap cars in the way. But they all have the potential to win this one, especially Anton, who doesn't have any penalties himself. I don't know what his pace is like, but it's someone that we can't afford to underestimate. We've just got to get on with the job and run away with this race as we get ready for the restart. Up in a rich and overtake. The Ferrari has jumped the gun a little bit early there. Hopefully there's no kerfuffling. There is a yellow flag behind, but no one has crashed, thankfully. So off we go for the restart. Down into turn one. We actually managed to pull up for the corner on this restart, which is nice to see. But yeah, this is going to be a big test for us now as Onko on the softs looks a little bit more racy than what he was coming out of the pit lane prior to the safety car. He takes the lead of the Grand Prix going into the middle sector. I'm playing it pretty calm, if I'm honest. I'm not using much overtake or any at all. I do know that he's got a 3-second time penalty, so we don't need to win the race on track, but I would certainly like to. The thought here is that if he wants to burn his ERS, his battery, early on, then I'm going to, you know, let him do that, because that's going to leave him a little bit vulnerable later on in the race, because it's so hard to recover ERS here. And if I can just stay with him, wait for the DRS to get enabled, which is now, he's not outside of a second. I'm guessing his game plan was to break away as quickly as possible, get outside of 3 seconds and win the race that way. But I've saved up my ERS, and now I'm charged up and ready to have an all-out attack at him now in the final 3 laps of this race. So we're getting towards the business end now. Anton, I'm not sure, has the pace to stay with us. Did have to overtake a few lap cars, to be fair to him. But it looks like it's going to be a 1v1 for this race between myself and the Racing Point driver. And I'm getting geared up to overtake him on this straight. So here we go, up in a rich overtake. DRS is open. We'll swiftly turn off the overtake button, because even though we saved it, it's very easy to lose it. So we've got to save it again for the last 2 laps, which is now. Here we go, up the inside into turn 2. He has a little lunge there into turn 3. We leave him the space. We get the better exit. And now we're up into the lead and holding on to it for this Bahrain Grand Prix, but only for a matter of seconds, as this straight is swiftly followed by, a DRS straight, and he's able to get up the inside into the middle sector. I'm heading on to the last lap in just a few moments, and I'm starting to think about where I'm going to position myself relative to how I'm going to win this race on track. We're still side by side going around the lap. This is so sketchy, because that last, right corner, we could have easily crashed out, and Anton could have came out of nowhere and won this race. But thankfully, we've kept it sensible, and we're able to still battle. It is the last lap now, and I've saved up a bit of ERS. I'm now deploying it in 8th gear to keep the top end speed ahead of Onko. Down into turn 1, going defensive. He has a little lunge at turn 2. The gap was closing, and this is a really good battle. Really having to think quite smart, battle quite defensively, and we're able to hang on for the time being. He's not close enough to have a lunge on this DRS straight, so he's going to have to get the job done into the last corner if he wants to overtake me on the track. But there's really no more DRS zones for the rest of this race now, so that is certainly going to help me. That's a big advantage that I had in winning that battle earlier on in this lap. So coming to the final corner now, it looks like we are going to win the Bahrain Shorts Grand Prix, the Sakhir Grand Prix, with absolutely no warnings against my name. Take that. I don't even have haters. I don't know what I'm talking about. But there we go. We have won. Pretty good race in the end there. We got out to a big lead early on, but then through, some reason or another, it got evaporated. And to be fair, to Esteban Ocon, had really good pace and was really keeping me honest there throughout the rest of the race. You can see I'm absolutely ecstatic about that win. But there we go. There was so many fast drivers in this lobby, but for whatever reason, things just never materialized for them. Here's what my podium celebration looked like for the rest of the lobby. There's something out of a horror film or something. But there you go. So many fast drivers, and like I said, they for some reason, it didn't come into fruition for them. Hoopalicious, I'm looking at you. Yellowish Star, pretty fast driver as well. Nothing came of that. And then that driver in the Haas, I think it was Attack Jacka, the one who overtook me into the pit lane. He had good pace too, but for whatever reason, was never there or thereabouts. Maybe got caught up with incidents with other people, which really set them back. So that was the Grand Prix. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Leave a like if you did. Subscribe to the channel if you're new to see plenty more racing game content. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram, like I said, to get involved. And I will see you guys very soon for another video. We did one more race after this, actually. It was Survive Monaco, and it was a good one. So stay tuned for that, and I'll see you guys very shortly for another video.